Hello, I'm Erik-Jan Hulting and I'm a professor of new product marketing at the Delft University of Technology in the Netherlands. Delft is a partner in the RECAP project that aims to improve collaboration among different partners in the food development value chain. And the objective of the research that was conducted here in Delft was to investigate which innovation management models firms use if they want to develop new food products in networks in cooperation with other companies. There are very few organizations nowadays that can survive on their current product offerings alone. Hence, for most organizations, innovation has become a necessity. And for most organizations in the food sector, this is no exception. Traditionally, most firms relied on themselves for innovation. They generated their own ideas, they developed their own concepts, and they brought their own new products to market. But this has become too time-consuming and too expensive. Hence, more and more firms are relying on an approach which is called open innovation. In this approach, firms collaborate with other partners, for example, technology suppliers, machinery suppliers, and retailers to bring new products to the market. An interesting finding in the literature is that the best performing firms in innovation are better in innovation, but they are especially better in bringing radically new products to the market. And these are products that are based on radically new technologies. For that reason, in our research, we were very curious to know what kind of processes firms use if they want to bring new products to the market that are based on radically new technologies. The main question that our research aimed to answer was to identify which innovation management models firms used to develop new food products in close collaboration with external partners. And to reach this objective, we conducted multiple cases. And we talked to several respondents from 5 different European countries, from Holland, Spain, France, Germany, and England. And we talked to food suppliers, machinery suppliers, technology suppliers, and even retailers to get a full comprehensive view on all those factors that are important when new food products are innovated via open innovation. To discuss our results, we distinguish between enablers and challengers of open innovation. So some of the factors that we found are really helpful when you want to develop new food products in close collaboration with partners, while others are challenges that firms need to face and need to solve. Our case study results showed that firms move through 3 different stages when they want to bring new products based on radically new technologies to the market. The first stage is called the technology development stage. In this stage, which is a very exploratory, trial and error kind of stage, new applications for the new technology are being identified and explored. After this stage has been sorted out, then we move into the new product development stage, where it's much clearer what the food manufacturer wants to achieve and what kind of new product they want to develop. After the second stage, the new product development stage, then finally the new product can be introduced into the marketplace. When a food manufacturer has decided that it wants to explore open innovation, of course it first needs to identify what partners they can possibly work with. And the first step that most food manufacturers take is to look in their own networks. But what our results actually find is that the technologies that they're looking for, the parties that they would like to work with, are actually not available or not existent in their own networks. So they need to look further. Normally they first resort to search engines and the like to explore what kind of firms are available that could possibly have the technologies that they're looking for. And if they found a few, then how do you make the selection which one to go for? And one of the most important findings that we have identified so far is that it's very important to work with parties that have a reputation for innovation, that have been very successful with innovation in the past, because collaborating with them can be helpful for both sides. Apart from having an innovative image as an important enabler for successful open innovation, we also identified several other enablers for successful innovation in our research. However, we also found some drawbacks, some challenges that need to be overcome. If you would like to know more about it, please visit the RECAP website, and there are many additional readings that may be of interest for you. Thank you very much.